Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. Solutions. We all want solutions to COVID-19 and any pathogen in the air. A vaccine at this time of history is one of them, but there's another solution, and it's in Bristol, New Hampshire, at a company called Air Cleaners, Inc. And it's a solution that, if it's true, and if what they claim can happen, it could help bring people back to work, children back to school, and patients back to their doctor. The clean air curtain, it creates an air barrier, indoor spaces such as schoolrooms and commercial spaces. It combines HEPA filtration, ultraviolet irradiation, and an air curtain. It captures and kills, quote, 99.995% of particles in seconds, such as COVID-19. And with me to describe this in more detail, the air curtain technology and how it kills airborne pathogens, is the president and CEO of Air Cleaners, Inc. in Bristol, Paul Bemis. Welcome.
Hi, Fred. Thanks for having me on the program
today.
Nice
to have you on the program. And you have an expertise in fluid dynamics and airflow, which is very relevant here.
Yes, it is. I do. I have quite a background in it. I am a mechanical engineer undergraduate, University of New Hampshire, as a matter of fact, New Hampshire boy.
What is the air curtain? Just briefly give us a description.
Well, the long and short of it, Fred, is that it's a HEPA filter and a UV light. That part of it is not unique. Others have done that in the industry. What we've done to differentiate it is we've combined it with an air curtain. An air curtain is not a physical curtain. It's a virtual curtain. It's an air that comes up very fast between you and another airspace. It either protects you from others or protects two airspaces from one another. But the other key thing here is that the high velocity creates a plume of air that goes up and mixes the air in the room, and it reduces the concentration of pathogens very rapidly due to this high velocity air coming out of it with 100% clean, pure air.
And let's show how that happens. Just describe what we're looking at.
Well, here we have two people sitting across from one another. This is done using computational fluid dynamics, same kind of technology used in aerospace and automotive. And on the left, you have a situation without the air curtain in place. And on the right, you have a situation with the air curtain in place. And you'll notice on the right, it's much cleaner. Clean is blue. Pathogens are red in this animation. And it just cleans the entire room and blocks any kind of pathogen from one person to another. Really quite simple.
Wow, interesting. And then you also gave us another animation. And this is a school classroom with a clean air curtain technology in the classroom. What are we looking at here?
That's correct. We have one in the at the teacher's desk and one in the back of the room, and we're able to show in a normal classroom the ability to drive down the concentration of pathogen in the room by 50% with just two units in the room, well below what we think is necessary to create a reaction or an infection in your lungs. So this has been shown to work not only as a separation, but also as a way to reduce the overall concentration of pathogens very quickly inside a room with 100% clean air.
I understand that you're already teaming up with a national organization of school superintendents and education leaders to help public school districts across the country.
That's correct.
Tell me about that.
There's several places we think this makes a lot of sense, schools being one of them. Remember the teachers in the room all day long and being exposed possibly to people coming and going. This is a way to protect them. It's a way to protect the environment, drive down pathogens. Many of these schools, Fred, as you know, are very old. The heating cooling systems in these schools are very old, and the cost to modify them to be more protective is really high. The cost of these units is fairly low. You can put one or two of them in a room and just drive down the concentration and make everybody safer.
Roughly, what is the cost per unit, depending on what unit you buy, of course?
The cost of the units is about $1,500 in general. It does depend which models you buy. They go a little higher than that and a little lower than that, but just around $1,500.
And I understand it's patented.
It is patent pending on it. There was no patents out there on this, so we went ahead and did a utility patent on it. It is pending.
So you're a startup. Are you ready to gear up to manufacture this? Because once this hits the airwaves and the print media, you'll be inundated, I would think.
Well, we think so. We've procured advanced supplies of both filters and blowers, the two most important things in it. We're working with a contract manufacturer in Tilton, New Hampshire called Spinnaker. We're thrilled to be working with them. This
Great.
Is a pure New Hampshire solution from one end to another. And we think we can meet demand. Now, of course, we could be overwhelmed, but that's a problem. That's another problem to have. It's the problem you want to have when you're in a startup business, and one we'll deal with.
Exactly. Paul Bemis, President and CEO of Air Cleaners, Inc. in Bristol, New Hampshire. Thank you.